I'm going to play a fourth game. They started the game with the king's pawn, one of the most common first moves in chess. And I've done the king's pawn open as well. And now these pawns won't be able to move. Oh wait, the next move I want to play is actually knight f6. Because then I'll be able to take the pawn on. And I will be forking the f pawn and the d. And if I take the f pawn, then it would be a checkmate if I move my queen to d4. And I'm forking the queen and the rook. So if they move their queen out of the way, I take the rook. And now, as they move their king out of the way, the best move would be for me to take the queen. As they may take my rook back, but I will have won a queen, which is worth three times more than that. And if they take this pawn, then I'll do a check on g4. I don't mean anything by this check. But on the next move, I'm planning to move my bishop to b4. And they'll be able to castle. So far, I think I'm doing very well in this game. And I could always take this pawn on d5, but taking the pawn on d2 wouldn't be a very good move. And of course, to move the bishop out of the way, I could do bishop takes four. I'd win a pawn and a castle, which would keep my king safe. Of course, if I take the pawn, I could put my bishop on the three in the c3 square. If not taking, then I would take the rook. I am up by 6 points. Actually, I'm up 7 points. Which is about as much as 4 pawns and a knight. And my opponent still has not moved out of check yet. But if they don't do it in 4 minutes, then I will have automatically won. Oh, they abandoned the game.